Hi, my name is Michael Marzio. I maintain a website with videos and lessons for people learning English as a second or foreign language. In 2007, I received a message from Sandy Lin, an associate professor of ESL in San Diego, explaining how my closed caption videos were useful for her mixed classes, including both deaf and hearing students. I posted her very interesting remarks on my first blog, as you can see below. 3 years later, a deaf Kenyan named Zachariah made a 23rd comment to this post. He explained that he had been conditionally accepted by the English Language Institute of Gallaudet University, one of the foremost schools for the deaf, located in Washington, D.C. As is the case for all universities, conditionally accepted means that a student is accepted if he can pay for his tuition. He wrote on this blog, "Hi, I am deaf from Kenya. I want to ask you help for college fees in Gallaudet. I come from poor family. I have admission letter. I can begin class on August. Can you help me? Please help me." The simplicity of his message hit me hard. It was time for me to help open a door of opportunity for someone else, just like I was given financial aid myself and able to go to college a long time ago. I did my research, contacting two administrators at Gallaudet University, and despite my fear of giving Zachariah more hope than tuition money, I gave myself my first mission in charitable fundraising for a person I had begun to truly understand and appreciate. Zachariah is poor but resourceful. After receiving his conditional letter of acceptance, he did research on the internet using a computer which he borrowed from a friend. In his search for tuition fees, he contacted sites and blogs having a connection to English as a second language and American Sign Language. I was the only person who replied to him. As I began preparing my campaign, my colleague suggested that a video of Zachariah would be a big help in a fundraising effort. So I asked Zach to find a friend with a video camera. He succeeded in getting a professional photographer, Peter, of Photoplace Studios in Naivasha, Kenya, to do the filming. Alice, whom you will meet in this video, voluntarily served as interviewer and interpreter. Peter and Alice were therefore the very first contributors to Zachariah's fundraising campaign, and all thanks to Zachariah's own initiatives. Please contribute whatever you can. If 3,000 people donate $10, the tuition fees of $27,000 will be covered, as well as $3,000 for his expenses, such as airfare. We have to do this quickly so that Zach can be sure of beginning classes shortly after the next payment deadline in November. Please contribute.
Now, we are happy to meet you, but we have few questions to ask you. Now, first question. What is your name? Okay, he says his name is Zachariah Gesho Gitonga.
Which is your nickname?
Okay.
He says he doesn't have a nickname of a word, but he has a nickname of a sign language, of which he has a black spot near his left eye, and all the deaf, they understand him by that spot. So when you show a spot on, if you put your finger on your left side, then the deaf will understand that you are asking about Zachariah Ngesho. But he doesn't have any name of a word. Okay, another question. Were you born deaf or not? Were you born deaf or not? Okay, he says he was not born deaf, but he became deaf after 7 years being born with hearing person, but after 7 years he became sick and he became deaf. Then he was taken from a hearing school to a deaf school. Another question for you. How was your child life? Hard or simple with other children? How? Okay. His life was so good and well when he was hearing. But when he became deaf, he was unable to communicate with hearing people. Do you have a wife? Okay, he says that he is not married because he is still young and he is not enough satisfied with life he is living now. So he says that if he gets scholarship and go to America and learn, then later after coming back to Kenya, he will be able to get married. When you come to Mali, will you Mali a deaf person or a hearing person? Okay. He says that if he finish his university in America, after coming to Kenya, he will find a girl is either hearing or deaf according to his love. Just a person whom he will be able to love, and the girl she will be able to love him according to his disability. If you go to America there and learn and finish your education, then are you willing to stay in America or you are coming back to Kenya? Okay. He says if he gets money to go to America for a university to learn about English language, he will be able, after getting his degree, he will be back to Kenya and he will be able to help other devs who doesn't understand English language. He can open his own school, then he can employ teachers who can be able to teach the deaf about the English language. Okay, now, you have a friend by name Mike. Mike, from where you started with him up to now, what do you want to tell him?
Okay, Tom, I can help him.
Okay. He says he is very, very, very glad since he met his friend Mike from France. He is very, very happy with him because he has tried all the ways to help him. Now, they meet in the computer. Through emails, they have communicated in different ways, and the friend is trying to seek another people to support him to go to America and get his aim in America. How can you tell Mike? Okay, he says he wishes his friend Mike all the best in his life, and also he wants to ask him to try to hurry up to support him so that in early January he gets all his needs to the American university so that he can be able to join the university as early as possible.